What do fine chocolates and alpacas have in common? For the answer, we go to Fife and Laurel McQuaid.
A waterfall of chocolate.
This is Emily's Chocolates. On the day of our visit, workers were carefully crafting delicious chocolate-covered caramels sprinkled with a touch of sea salt. Our guide is company president, Amy Paulos.
This is a fan of warm air, so it levels off the consistency of the chocolate, so you have an even coating.
The story begins several decades ago when George Paulos emigrated from India to work at Weyerhaeuser. In 1987, he founded Ames International so that other family members would have work when they came to America. The name, Ames, is derived from his wife's and two daughters' names. The company began by importing cashews from India. When they acquired a chocolate factory, youngest daughter, Emily, lent her name to the new products. She was around 5 years old at the time.
The story that I tell is she is younger, cuter, and at that time certainly more gullible than I was. And so it was a bit of a negotiation for a Game Boy at the time between, if you take the name, we'll get a Game Boy and an unlimited supply of ice cream. The Game Boy, I don't think, came true. The unlimited supply of ice cream may have been a little bit more a part of the daily life.
The Fife Outlet Store is a potpourri of nuts, cookies, and chocolate delights.
Our core line, which is our Emily's chocolate-covered fruits, we have blueberries, strawberries, cherries. Most of the fruits are from the Pacific Northwest, and we make everything here on site. Dark chocolate-covered cherries is one of my favorite also.
Looking around the shop at the colorful and unique packaging, we couldn't help but notice the homage to Lucy and Ethel. That reminds us of the caramels being made just beyond the walls behind us.
And now they are heading to the cooling tunnel, which they'll go through three different temperature zones to properly cool and set the chocolate so that it has a nice shine and finish for you to enjoy in the end. The chocolate has gone through the cooling tunnel and is now coming to the end of our process where they will individually wrap each caramel piece and pack into the final shelf-ready display box.
Lucy and Ethel's dilemma is great comedy, but it's certainly no way to run a growing business.
We currently are in more than 23 different countries across the globe that import our products. So to definitely keep growing here in the US, but also to share the knowledge that we've generated over the last 25 years and develop and really sustain and help to create a thriving food processing industry in the country, in India as well.
In fact, one of the goals of the family's new facility in India is to help improve that country's food processing safety. Back here at home, the business has some personal benefits too.
To be with the family and to really create something that's your own, being your own boss, working with great people and adopting new family members, you get to carve your own path.
For the holidays, season traditions are wrapped together into a sweet morsel.
We do a white chocolate gingerbread fortune cookie, and it's a great interplay between the white chocolate, the creaminess of the white chocolate, but then the spicy notes of the gingerbread, and that really comes through. And then the fortune cookie is, of course, very iconic and lends itself well to the holiday season, and they have fun, festive holiday messages inside.
So what does Emily's have in common with alpacas? The answer is chocolate-covered raisins.
Taking some chocolate-covered raisins, which look very much similar to the droppings that the alpacas leave out in the pasture, and I wasn't sure how people would feel about that, but we did, and it's actually been very popular, especially with little kids. They love to tell their parents that they're eating poo.
Welcome to Firwood Alpaca Farm and Leanna Stidham. The farm is named after this neighborhood, now part of Fife, and the elementary school that Leanna attended.
I realized I love animals, and so I didn't want something in our pasture that was going to end up on the dinner table.
Firwood Alpaca Farm began in 2006 when Leanna and her husband bought 4 pregnant females and 2 male alpacas.
We have this place now where we're open all the time so people can come in, and a lot of kids who don't live on the farm or have never seen or been able to feed chickens, they can come out, feed the alpacas, feed the chickens, go in the chicken house and get a fresh egg and take home. So it's a fun thing to do for kids and just to introduce people to a different animal that a lot of them have never seen before.
Firwood is more than a small business. It's also a sanctuary. The 2008 recession caused many alpaca farmers to close shop, putting hundreds of animals in need of rescue.
A farm in Oregon that had almost 200 alpacas that were starving and needed to be rehomed. We have three of those here from that rescue. Just recently, there were some up in the Mount Vernon area. An elderly gentleman had a herd of over 50, and he was hospitalized and won't be, you know, going back home and can't care for him. So we recently fostered four of those that are still here that I'm trying to find homes for.
Sheep grow wool. Other animals grow fur or hair. What the alpacas grow is called fiber.
Alpaca fiber is warm like wool, but tends to be soft like cashmere.
As the animals grow older, the fiber tends to be a little more coarse and is used to weave rugs. The Cozy Farm Store, now open throughout the year, is full of natural and colorful yarns woven from the alpaca fiber. Many of the yarns are personalized, the tags showcasing the animals who supplied the fiber.
So we also have sweaters made from alpaca, sweaters and shawls, different styles, different colors. Alpaca sweaters are super soft and very warm.
Like Emily's chocolate-covered raisins, you'll find other products made by local artisans, and all of the Firwood fiber is milled locally.
There's one up in Edmonds that we use, and another one down in Montesano. One's in a couple's garage, the other is in a couple's barn, and they wash and process that fiber for us, and then they send it back to us as yarn, which I then sell in the shop here.
Alpacas may not lend the magical powers that lift Santa's sleigh, but these precocious characters and their farm will certainly provide for some holiday and year-round memories. Learn more about Emily's chocolates and the Firwood Alpaca Farm by visiting their websites.